Hello everyone, how are you all? I hope you all are staying safe at home. Children, today we are going to start our next chapter, that is chapter number 15, Bhalu the Bear part 3 from your English literature book, that is New Radiant Readers. Now, open the book to page number 75, chapter 15, Bhalu the Bear part 3. Children, I'll read out the entire chapter in front of you all, then I'll give you a short summary about this chapter. So let's start with reading. Listen carefully to improve your pronunciation, especially of the new words. Chapter 15, Bhalu the Bear part 3. Bhalu squealed as loudly as he could, and he cries woke up an old grey monkey who lived in the trees just above Mother Bear's cave. She peered through the branches and saw Sher slinking away with the little bear in his jaws. Now Mother Bear was a friend of the monkey people, and the old monkey had heard her saying where she was going that evening. So the monkey lost no time in setting off for the orchard on the hill, chattering to herself as she swung from tree to tree. Children, meaning of squealed is a long high-pitched cry, and meaning of slinking is move quietly. Okay. Mother Bear had a fine time in the orchard. She had tasted the fruit of all the best trees, one after another, and she collected a few good apples for Bhalu and Chota too. She was just returning home when she heard the chatter, chatter, chatter of the old grey monkey overhead. "Your cub has been carried off by Sher," said the grey monkey. Mother Bear's hair rose all along her back, and she gave a fierce growl. Dropping the apples right and left, she set off at a trot for her home. Children, meaning of fierce is angry, aggressive and frightening. And meaning of growl is make a low, hostile sound. Okay. And meaning of trot is to run. Meanwhile, Sher had carried Bhalu into his den and was playing with him just as a cat plays with a mouse. How Bhalu longed for his warm furry mother and his sleepy little sister. He squealed loudly as Sher began to grow rougher and rougher in his play. Suddenly, a black body sprang onto a rock which overhung the tiger's den, and Bhalu gave a gasp of joy. Mother Bear, growling angrily, leaped from the rock straight on top of Sher's back. Children, meaning of sprang is move or jump suddenly. The bear and the tiger rolled over and over, snarling at each other. Mother Bear was trying hard to get the tiger's body into her grip so that she could hug him to death in her strong arms. But she found that the tiger was not easily held. Indeed, the fight might have gone badly for the old bear if a shot had not rung out suddenly from somewhere near. The tiger, with a snarl of rage, meaning of rage is uncontrollable anger, sprang from the den and flashed away, for he knew the man, his greatest enemy, was close by. Children, meaning of flashed is move very fast. Mother Bear caught Bhalu up in her strong teeth and bore him swiftly through the jungle. She did not stop till she was in the darkness of her own den. There she set her child down with a thump, and she herself sat down to lick her bites and bruises. Chota was still sleeping peacefully where Bhalu had left her. He crept up and cuddled his shivering, bruised little body against her warm, soft fur. For a while, he watched his mother as she licked and grunted. Then his bright eyes slowly closed and he fell asleep, a sadder and wiser little bear. Now, children, meaning of cuddled is hold close in one's arm, or as a way of some showing love. Okay. And meaning of shivering is trembling movement. Meaning of bruised is an injury appearing as discolored skin on the body caused by a blow. And meaning of grunted is a low, short, guttural sound. Okay. So children, come to the explanation of the chapter. Children, in the last videos, I had already explained two parts of this chapter, that is chapter number 13 and 14. Today, I will be starting with the third part of this chapter, that is chapter 15, Bhalu the Bear, part 3. Okay. But before I start, I would like to summarize the story of first and second part of this chapter, that is chapter number 13 and 14. Okay. Children, only just a small part I'll explain you. Okay. First part was based on Bhalu and his mother. They lived in a cave which was in the Himalayas. Bhalu was a mischief cub. His nose was always sniffing. His sister's name was Chota. So Mother Bear always used to beat Bhalu only because of his bad behavior. Bhalu never agrees with his mother. His mother always used to go for hunt at night, and in daytime she used to sleep. But sometimes she remains awake and tells stories about the world. About the world and the greatest enemy of the jungle, that is Sher, the tiger. One day his mother went to orchard, and before leaving the cave, she warned her cubs about the Sher. She said that Sher is roaming for his prey, so please don't go inside or don't look outside. Okay. Children, now come to the explanation of this of the second part. In second part of this chapter, it was a moonlight with warm air and sweet. Bhalu and Chota both were busy to opening the nuts which their mother has given. They both fighting and playing. After this, Chota, who was always feeling sleepy, she went to sleep on a hollow place on the floor. Then Bhalu made a plan to go outside the cave for a little walk, and by rolling himself, he moved out from the cave and said by himself that his mother always talking nonsense. There is nothing to scare. In fact, there are only twittering and chattering of monkeys. The different voices of animals are coming. Suddenly, the roar of the tiger he heard, and in front of him, tiger was standing. And after that, tiger pounced him and he seized him by the skin of his neck and began to carry him in the jungle. Now, children, come to the explanation of third part of this chapter, that is chapter 15, Bhalu the Bear, part 3. Now, children, in this chapter, Bhalu squealed. Children, meaning of squealed is to make a loud high noise because of pain, fear. So Bhalu makes a loud high noise as loudly he can, and he is cries by hearing a loud cry an old grey monkey wake up, who lived just above the mother bear's cave. Okay, she saw through the branches. That Sher slinking, children, meaning of slinking is to move somewhere slowly and quietly because you do not want anyone to see you. Often when you feel guilty, so children, he moves very slowly and quietly with the little bear in his jaws so that no one can see him. But Mother Bear was a friend of the monkey people. Now the old monkey heard that time about where the Mother Bear has gone away that evening. So without wasting any time, all the monkeys moved to the orchard on the hill by talking from tree to tree. Okay. Now, Mother Bear was enjoying good time in the orchard by tasting the fruit of all the best trees, and she collected the few good apples to them for Bhalu and Chota. When she was returning back, suddenly she heard the chatter or talking old grey monkey just overhead. Then old grey monkey said that or informed that your cub has been taken away by Sher. Okay. Now come to this paragraph. Now children, after listening this, the hair rose all along her back. Children, hair, her means mother bear. Then she gave a fierce growl. Children, meaning of fierce is angry, and meaning of growl is to make a low noise in the throat, to show anger or to give a warning. So mother bear to make a low noise in the throat to show anger or to give warning to share. Mother bear dropped the apples and she trot for her home. Children, meaning of trot is to move forward at a speed that is faster than a walk. So mother bear also moved very speedily towards her home. Okay. Now come to this paragraph. But Sher had already carried Bhalu to his den, and there he started to play with Bhalu like a cat plays with a mouse. In the same way, Sher also played with Bhalu. Now Bhalu make a loud high noise because of pain, because Sher started playing very rougher and rougher. So children, suddenly a black body sprang to a rock. Children, meaning of sprang is to jump or move quickly. Okay, so to a rock which was hung, the tiger's den. And Bhalu gave a gasp of joy. Children, meaning of gasp is to is a short, quick breath of air that you take in through your mouth, especially when you are surprised or shocked or in pain. Mother bear then gave a warning in a very angry mood, and she jumped high from the rock directly on the top of Sher's back. Okay, now come to this paragraph. Now children, what would happen? Okay, the bear and the tiger rolled over and over by making an angry sound or to show anger at each other. Mother bear was trying very hard to hold the tiger's body into her arms so that she hugged in a way by which his death in her strong arms. But tiger was very strong, okay, and she was not able to easily hold him. Perhaps the fight have gone very badly, but they heard the sound of shot suddenly from somewhere. Okay. The tiger's anger was uncontrollable, but after listening the voice of shot, he moved with anger from the den and moved away very fast from there, because he knew that the man, that is hunter, is the greatest enemy, was very close to him. That's why he ran away. Okay. Now come to this paragraph. Now children, mother bear took Bhalu into her strong teeth and moved away very slowly through the jungle. So she did not stop till she was in the darkness of her own den. So children, she never stopped till when she reached her den. Then she take their children down with a thumb and she started licking. Okay. Now children, in this paragraph, Chota was still sleeping where Bhalu leave her. He crawled up and hold close in one's arm as a way of showing love, with trembling movement, threw a little body against her soft warm fur. Then he looked his mother and she licked with low sound. Then his bright eyes slowly closed and he fell asleep, a sadder and wiser little bear. Okay children, now there is an end of this chapter. I hope you all have understood all the three parts of this chapter very nicely. Okay children, thank you.